A beautiful day in the neighborhood, but something is not right. Up on this high voltage power pole, an inch away from a live wire, a cat on a hot transformer.
I think it could become electrocuted. My concern right now is that it's dehydrated.
Carol Jepson spotted the pet panting, peering down, pondering.
The guys that are back there working said it's been up there for 3 days.
It was a job too big.
It's not worth getting killed over.
For animal control officer Kevin Lemon.
It's got a collar on it, so it's somebody's cat.
Painters saw what happened.
Actually, the cat chased the squirrel up the pole. And the squirrel went to the top of the pole and the cat sat on the transformer and couldn't get back down. The squirrel went and got another squirrel and they taunted the cat for 2 days.
That's a cat that's got a problem.
Mid-American Energy called to the rescue. Greg Murray shuts down the power, climbs up, and coaxes the scared cat.
No, don't jump.
Murray finally grabs him.
He wasn't too happy to see me.
It's okay, kitty. He's got you. He's got you. He's got you.
But gets caught on the cable line, where the claws come out and the paws hang on for dear life.
Oh, yeah, hang on, baby.
Until they can hold on no more.
Oh. Here she comes. Oh.
She's on. She's down.
If cats always land on their feet.
Where'd she go?
That way.
Those paws took off.
Lucky. They should name the cat Lucky.
He was about 1 foot from the actual voltage.
And how powerful?
7,620 volts.
Although the cat with 9 lives could not be found, at least he's on the ground.
Happy ending. It's great. And I'm glad everybody pulled together and got it done.